Hello and welcome to this video where I show you how you can register for all your first semester courses in the Master of Ecotoxicology and the Master of Environmental Sciences. So in the near future you will receive such a list as you can see here, where you have all the lectures for the first semester listed. And just to give you an idea, on the right hand side you can see this little timetable that details all your first semester courses that you should take and the fact to which module each of this course belongs. And as you can see here, we have 5 modules in the ecotoxicology, so ETX 1 to 5, and each consists of 2 lectures. Very importantly, for the Master of Environmental Sciences, this is very, very similar. You also have 5 compulsory modules. Each of those consists of 2 lectures. So while those names may differ and the list that you may receive may also be different, the general approach here is more or less identical. And then there are maybe some other optional courses here. There's only one for the ecotoxicology, which is a tutorial that aids you in the advanced environmental chemistry course. So if you are asking yourself where I have this little timetable from, it is out of the module handbook, and I want to quickly show you what the module handbook is and why it is important for you. Again, in this case I'll do it based on the module handbook for the ecotoxicology, but for the environmental sciences this is identical. So on the last side, or the last page of the module handbook, you can see this overview, and that's what I added into your list. Now if you go to the top, then you can see this document always starts like that. Now the module handbook is very handy for you because it provides you a comprehensive overview of all modules, may they be compulsory or optional, throughout your study. And so to give you an idea, maybe let's look at the ETX5 module. We click on it here and we are brought to this page. And as you can see, there is a lot of information given for all of these modules. The name of both of the courses that are in, the semester you're supposed to take it, and the coordinators, and so on. The teaching format, the targeted learning outcomes. So I don't want to go over those in detail because you can, or you should, read up on those anyways, but as you can see, there is a plethora of information for you in order to prepare yourself properly for your studies. So let's go back to registering for your courses. In this list that you will receive, you can see here the module shortcode or the module name. In this case it's ETX1 here, which room it is currently assigned to, and most importantly we provided you with a direct clips link. That is so that you can simply click on the link and then you will be brought to the clips portal, which is our general registration portal where you register for all of our courses in the studies. And there's also the VSD number, so that's the in German Veranstaltungsnummer, or in English it would be the course number. This is also something that you can use simply to find your lecture. So let's try out the aquatic ecotoxicology, for instance. So we click on this link and it will bring up the entry in clips. Now before we go there, I also want to show you how you can get there without the link, because it's rather straightforward. So let's assume we load into clips, as you have learned after your introduction, and then you are greeted by this starting page. We can change the language on the top right hand side, so let's click on the flag here, and now you're in the English version. So we are looking for a course, so we click on course and then we search for a lecture, and here as well you can search for it. So let's clear this, let's select the right semester, that's the winter semester, and we are looking for aquatic ecotoxicology, so we can also try to use the module shortcode and start the search, and you can see even the module shortcode works for most lectures. And so we can click on it and we end up in the same window. Now, before we are starting with the registration, I want to quickly point out what the information is that you can see here, because there are a lot of, well, different details that are important for you. Up here you get a great overview of everything that is relevant to the course. So in this case it's a lecture that is always taking place in the winter semester. It is every second semester, so annually. Languages in English, and there are other details as well, such as the maximum participants and so on. There's also a short URL code, which is quite handy, so you don't have to copy this long string up here. And before we go to registering, I want to show you the other information as well. So here you have the date, times, location, and that means you see here that the course takes place on Wednesdays from 10 to 12. It does so each week, and this is the window, the date window when this lecture takes place. So from 4th of November till the 10th of February. You can look up the room and the building. So if you are unsure where to find the building, then just click on it here and it will bring up this little map. And well, we have to zoom in a bit, and it shows you exactly the either the room or the building that you are searching for. In this case it's C4, and that is also very handy, especially if you are new. And then there's additional information such as the lecturer, but it's also something that you can find down here, and it's very important because if you may have some questions, then you can contact the lecturer directly. And you also see that this is assigned to the MSc of Environmental Sciences. Normally it should also list MSc of Ecotoxicology, if I'm not mistaken, but that's nothing of concern here. Importantly also, you can see the exams or the module exams. That's something we will go over briefly in just a second. And then down here there are additional descriptions, comments, literature, recommendations, and so on, which the lecturer can provide. So this is also something you should look up just to get a better idea on what the lecture offers or what it may require from you. So back to applying. Now, if you want to apply, then you can click on it here. As you can see, apply now, or you can also cancel your application so you can deregister. Both of them are equally as important. So in this case, let's try to apply, and you can see that application is currently not allowed because at the time that I am recording this video, the application window is not open. And that is a very important information. So if I would like to register and the application window is open, then you would get a button here, and then it is more or less self-explanatory. However, these registration windows is something that always cause some confusion or even concern. And that's why I want to briefly go over them and explain them to them. First of all, before we begin, unfortunately, some of the German phrases or words are not properly translated. And so two words in particular have to be explained. The important one is probably Belegphase, such as this here, which means it's the registration phase. And as you can see, there are three registration phases or Belegphasen, the first one, the second one, and the third one. And there's also a deregistration phase, which is the Abmeldephase, which you can see here. So for a first semester, there are these three registration windows where you can register for a course starting from numerous dates. And there's also a deregistration phase that ranges up until the 6th of December. So a little bit later in the winter term, you can still deregister until the 6th of December. Registering is very important because if you do not register for a course, you do not get a seat assigned, and you are also not eligible to partake in the module exam. And another thing is, while there are three registering phases here, If you're in the second semester or later, then you only have to, you no longer have this orientation phase, which is only for first semesters. However, for you, all of those registration phases apply. And so it is important that during one of those registration phases, preferably before the lecture phase begins, so not in the third one, but rather in the second or even in the first if you have time for it, that you already register for all the courses that we provide in our overview. And if you do not plan anymore to take part in a certain lecture, it's also very important that you deregister for them. It is used for planning generally, and it can have also a binding effect. More importantly, I think you should now understand how to register or deregister for a course. The same applies to exams. It may be intuitively the impression that if you register for a course that you can also take part in the exam. That is not the case. You have to register for an exam or a module exam specifically. So in this case, you can see down here, the exam is the aquatic ecotoxicology exam, and it is for the Master of Science in Ecotoxicology, so that is exactly what you are looking for. And you would have to click on there and then register for it. Now, the registration window for exams, it is later, so probably in late January. The reason for this is that you can get an impression about a lecture and then see if you think that in this semester you are fit to really take part in the exam. If you feel unsure or think that your general workload may be too much, then you can decide not to register for the module exam or the exam. It is, however, extremely important to note that the registration for an exam is binding. That means if you register for an exam and you do not deregister from it, then it is one of your tries that you can take for an exam. So if you are registered but you do not show up because you think it's not you may not be prepared well enough, then this doesn't matter. It counts as if you would have handed in an empty copy of the exam sheet. So you have to deregister from it, otherwise it's a failed attempt. And you only have two attempts generally to fail. If you fail two times in a compulsory module, then you have a one-time chance to take a third try to get this exam. If you do not manage to pass the exam in the third try, then you are exmatriculated. If you have passed in the third try and then in another lecture you would also again need a third try, then you will still be exmatriculated because this third try only counts once for all of your compulsory modules. That means if that third try is wasted or used up, then you only have two tries left for every other compulsory module or exam. That means it is extremely important to correctly register or deregister from exams and to be aware of the gravity that is associated with an exam registration. I think that should make it clear for everybody, and if you have any questions, let us know. Yeah, and that is more or less everything that you have to know about the registration via CLIPS. Maybe we can go back to our list here. And so what you would do as an ecotoxicologist or also as an environmental scientist is you get this list here, and then you click on each link individually, apply for the course, and then you're more or less done. If you have done so, then normally CLIPS automatically generates a timetable or a schedule for you. And in my case, it's always a little bit different because in this case I'm a teacher, but to show you here, it is always under my functions and then you have your schedules. And you can see here, if I click on it, currently when I'm recording this video, there is nothing in this week. However, imagine if you have registered for a couple of courses and then you see, for instance, aquatic ecotoxicology, I think goes from 10 to 12 o'clock on Wednesdays, and so you can print that one out, and it directly reflects all the choices that you've made in clips, which is very handy for you and enables you to plan your time accordingly. Yes, that is mostly the important part. So maybe to quickly summarize again, registering is very important. It is as important as well to deregister from courses. It is even more important to properly register for exams so you can take part in them. And if you do not want to take part in the exam, that you also deregister from them so that you do not waste any tries on them. Now for the environmental sciences, I have no additional information, but for the ecotoxicologists, I quickly want to give you a heads up, just so, well, to prevent some confusion. First thing is, there are, as you can see, some lab courses here. I'll highlight them in yellow, and they're always at the end of the semester. That means between end of February to end of beginning of April. So here I cannot give you a room currently because this will still be declared, but that's not an issue for you. You can already register for it, and then you will get information on the place that it's going to happen. And the environmental chemistry lab course, something that always causes some confusion. You have to choose either of those, or better, you're not the one choosing, but rather there will be an evaluation of your pre-existing knowledge on environmental chemistry. And depending on how well you score in this evaluation, you will be assigned to either the basic or the advanced course. So you cannot take both. You are not supposed to take both. They will run in parallel, so it's not even possible to take both one of those, and you will be assigned to them. Please look up in clips when the evaluation will take place, and then you can take part in this evaluation, and you will be assigned to one of those courses. Yes, I think that is the most important information. One last thing, it is always important to register, because if you do not complete an exam, let's say for instance here the data analysis lecture, then it may be that you cannot take future courses. I think it is for instance ETX8, which is exposure effect and GIS application modeling. It requires you to have completed the ETX3 module, because there is some statistics happening, and so it is important for you to have this groundwork done. So register for your first semester courses and complete them, and then you are perfectly set to continue in the second and in the third semester. If you have any questions, please contact the study advisors, and for the rest of the semester, I wish you best of luck. I hope you settle in well, despite, well, all the challenges that may be posed to you. And hopefully you are in good health. And yes, best of luck to you, and see you soon.